Welcome to the International Telecommunication Union. I'm Heather Heywood, head of the ITU Library and Archives.
One of ITU's goals is actually to share knowledge. And for that, Heather, we have a journal télégraphique. Can you tell me more about this document?
Yes, people often think of ITU as being a very technical agency, but the members realized from the very beginning that it was very important for them to share information. So shortly after the founding of the International Telegraph Union in 1865, they mandated the Secretariat to publish a monthly journal. And in the pages of this journal, we find articles about the situation in different countries. Here we have an article on women in telegraph service, the conditions of work in the telegraph offices. We find experiments that are being done with the new technology and transmission of it, statistical information. This journal has been published monthly from 1869 up to present day, and there's really a wealth of information in it. Articles that are coming from the members with the intention of helping other members benefit from their knowledge.
So that's good literature, but there's also, in real life, people who are mandated experts that are going to help other experts or other technicians all around the world. Can you explain what we see here in this picture?
Yeah, this is a phase that started when ITU became the Specialized Agency for Telecommunications of the United Nations and was able to connect with the development program of the United Nations. So here we have an expert from Colombia who has been sent to Pakistan to help the operators in Pakistan understand how to maintain their equipment and to use their equipment.
So Heather, here's a map. Can you explain what we see? It's very complicated. There's a lot of data all around.
There is a lot of data. This is from 1970 and shows the state of cooperation projects in progress in 1970. We have the world. The different types of shading show countries that have received aid and other countries that have given aid, and sometimes there are countries that do both. All of the lines are showing what type of cooperation project is happening in that country, how many experts have been sent to assist them with their project, where the experts came from. So we see that it's really a global effort, and expertise is coming from one part of the world to another part of the world for certain types of technical questions, but for other questions, perhaps this part of the world is helping the other way around. So it's a global effort, and again, it really represents the heart of ITU's work, where the expertise is in our membership, and it's their willingness to share their knowledge for the benefit of everyone